وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى we're now going to go into the second part of the introduction to the Kitab Sunnah Abi Dawood. We've already spoken about and we dealt with Al-Imam Abi Dawood, the author of the book. And we spoke about him in two ways. We spoke about him, سيرته الشخصية and حياته العلمية. We spoke about his personal life, his upbringing, his family, whether he was married, did he have children, and etc. We spoke about that. And then we spoke about the second part, which is Al-Imam Abi Dawood, how was he as a person in terms of knowledge? And we dealt with that. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into the Kitab Sunan Abi Dawood, this book itself now. We're going to have an understanding of the book. And the way that I plan to speak about the book is, first of all, define the book. That's the first point. At-ta'rifu bi Sunan Abi Dawood. We need to define this book and understand what it is. Once we finish that, inshallah ta'ala, and we deal with that, we'll move on to the second part, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, which is منهج الإمام أبي داود في سننه. الإمام أبي داود, what's his methodology? What is the path that he chose for himself to tread on? For his book. That is the second part, inshallah ta'ala, that we will deal with, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. I hope, inshallah ta'ala, that I will be able to finish those two parts today. So tomorrow we can start the kitab straight away, inshallah ta'ala. The chapter of fasting, we can start it straight away. If not, then we might do the first part today, and we'll do the second part tomorrow. Let's start with the first part, At-ta'rifu bi Sunan al-Imam Abi Dawood. Let's define this book. The name of this book is called what? Sunan al-Imam Abi Dawood. That's the name of the book. So Ismul Kitab, the name of the book. This book has become famous, well known as what? As Sunan. It has that name, As Sunan. If you look at the cover of the book, it says As Sunan lil-Imam Abi Dawood. That's the name that it has. Al-Imam Abi Dawood, you know who he is. So he says As Sunan lil-Imam Abi Dawood. We know who Imam Abi Dawood is. But what does the word Sunan mean? And what does Sunan actually mean? Sunan is jam'u sunnah. It's the plural of what? Sunnah. So the word sunan is plural, and the singular is what? The singular is sunnah. And according to the jumhur al-ulama, according to the majority of the scholars, it is turadiful hadith. It's equal to hadith. The word sunan, sunnah, is equal to hadith. This is according to what? Jumhur al-ulama, the majority of scholars. But al-Imam Abi Dawood doesn't mean that meaning that the jumhur are talking about. Al-Imam Abi Dawood, he doesn't mean by the word as-sunan, jam'u sunnah, التي ترادف الحديث, that which is a synonym of hadith. He doesn't mean that. But what al-Imam Abi Dawood means from it is, as-sunanu huna, هي أحاديث الأحكام. It is meant by the أحاديث الأحكام. What is أحاديث الأحكام? أحاديث الأحكام are أحاديث that only deal with fiqh issues. They don't talk about heart softening. They don't talk about فضائل الأعمال. They don't talk about virtues of the Quran or virtues of the Ansar or virtues of the Muhajirin. It doesn't talk about that. It only deals with what? Ahadith al-Ahkam, specifically. Ahadith pertaining to fiqh-related matters. And now this teaches us that the scholars who authored books, their books were of different categories. Now, for example, if we look at Sahih al-Bukhari, written by who? Al-Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. His Sahih, is it Sunan? Is Sahih al-Bukhari a Sunan book? No. It's called a Jami'. And al-Jami' means that it has within it many different chapters. It has ahkam, it has fada'il, it has raqa'iq, it has fada'il al-a'mal, it has all of that. It has qisas, stories. All of those are in Bukhari. So Bukhari's kitab is a what? It's a comprehensive book. It has all of those ahadiths in it. Lakin al-Imam Abi Dawud lah. He specialized in what? Or his book is specific to ahadith al-ahkam. An example of ahadith al-ahkam is Bulugh al-Maram, Umdat al-ahkam. These are small versions of what? Sunan Abi Dawud is a smaller version. Umdat al-ahkam is ahadith al-ahkam. Bulugh al-Maram, ahadith al-ahkam. Like Riyad al-Salihin? No. Riyad al-Salihin is not ahadith al-ahkam. Are we all together? Riyad al-Salihin is fada'il al-a'mal, righteous deeds. The virtues that are connected to doing this. Like Bulugh al-Maram doesn't talk about that. Wala Umdat al-Ahkam, wala Sunan Abi Dawud, and the likes of it. Walidhalika, according to the scholars, Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi's kitab is not called a Sunan, if we're looking at the right definition then. It shouldn't be called Sunan al-Tirmidhi. What should it be called? Jami' al-Tirmidhi. That's the correct. And that's another discussion. So the author himself, rahimahullah, he gave this book this name. He called it As-Sunan. There's a book I told you we're gonna come to later. It was called Risalat Abi Dawood ila Ahli Makkah fi wasfi sunanihi. Abi Dawood is not like a lot of the scholars. Bukhari, for instance, he didn't describe his book. He didn't talk about his book. He didn't say, my book is going to do this, and it's going to have this, and this is why I wrote this, and this is why I placed this hadith here, and this is what I meant by this chaptering. Al-Imam al-Bukhari didn't do that. Al-Imam al-Bukhari wrote his book, and he left it. So Ibn Hajar came, and he read Sahih al-Bukhari, and he read it again, and again, and again, and again, and he understood this book so much, he placed for it a description, which he called it Hadyusari في شرح مقدمة صحيح البخاري. Oh, he called it Huda Sari. However way you want to call it. So Ibn Hajar gives us an understanding of صحيح البخاري. Are we together, brothers? And it falls in the beginning of Fathul Bari. If you want to have understanding of صحيح البخاري, you'd buy the Fathul Bari and you read the مقدمة, which is what? Hadyu Sari, Ama Huda Sari, and it will give you an extensive, detailed understanding of Sunan Sahih al-Bukhari. Of what? Sahih al-Bukhari. Lakin al-Imam Muslim, oh, he spoke about his book. Al-Imam Muslim, he spoke about his book and what he wanted from this book and why he placed it like this and why he laid it out like this. Al-Imam Muslim spoke about it. So that's why he made a muqaddimah for his Sahih. He made an introduction for it where he discusses all of that. Same is with who? Al-Imam Abi Dawood. Abi Dawood, when he wrote his Sunan, some people from Mecca, a people from what? A people from Mecca, they sent him a request, a letter, asking him to tell them about his Sunan. And Al-Imam Abi Dawood wrote what? He wrote a letter describing his Sunan. And he called it, or is called Risalat Abi Dawood ila Ahli Mecca, the letter of Al-Imam Abi Dawood to the people of Mecca fi wasfi sunanihi, in describing his sunan. In this letter of his, he says, فَإِنَّكُمْ سَأَلْتُمْ أَنْ أَذْكُرَ لَكُمُ الْأَحَادِيثَ. You have asked me, who is he saying this to? The people of Mecca. He's saying to them, فَإِنَّكُمْ سَأَلْتُمْ, you guys have asked me, أَنْ أَذْكُرَ لَكُمُ الْأَحَادِيثَ, you have asked me to tell you about the ahadith التي في كتاب السنن, that is inside the what? As-Sunan. So he called it what? What did he call the book? As-Sunan. So he named it that name. أهي أحصح ما عرفتم بال عرفتم بالباب. So he called it As-Sunan. What is the موضوع of the kitab? What does this book deal with? As we said to, as I said to you, موضوعه, what it deals with is أحاديث الأحكام. It talks about the hadith of, so it'll start with Kitab al-Tahara, Kitab al-Salah, al-Zakah, al-Sawm, and then what? Al-Hajj. And then this is Qism al-Ibadat, that's finished. And then Qism al-Mu'amalat is then come, then that comes what? Then that comes next. So he done it in what? It's in a fiqh. And it's specific to that. ولذلك, look what he said. And Imam Abi Dawood, look what he said. To tell you that this book is based upon ahadith al-ahkam, the author himself said, وَإِنَّمَا لَمْ أُصَنِّفْ فِي كِتَابِ السُّنَنِ إِلَّا الْأَحْكَامِ. I have not written, and I have not placed in this book, in this sunan, except ahadith al-ahkam, ahadith that are pertaining to fiqh related matters. وَلَمْ أُصَنِّفْ كُتُبَ الزُّهْدِ. And I have also not placed what? I have also not placed books that speak about zuhd, to be aesthetic, to boycott this dunya and to turn to hereafter. No. وَفَضَائِلَ الْأَعْمَالِ, and righteous deeds. I haven't placed it inside my sunan. وَغَيْرِهَا, and other than it. فَهَذِهِ الْأَرْبَعَةُ الْآلَافِ وَالثَّمَانِمِئَةِ, the 4,800 ahadith that are in my sunan, كُلُّهَا فِي الْأَحْكَامِ, all of them are in ahkam. So he specifically tells us that is sunan, it deals with what? What does it deal with? Ahadith al-ahkam. And the beauty about this book is, it is considered, as al-Imam al-Khattabi rahimahullah mentioned, that it's the first book that was written in ahadith al-ahkam. No one preceded him in this idea. Al-Imam Abi Dawood was the first to write a kitab in sunnah, in ahadith al-ahkam. No one surpassed him in that idea. Specific to that, a book that only deals with ahadith al-ahkam, he was the first to do that. Are we all together, brothers? ولذلك الإمام الخطابي رحمه الله, he says in his kitab معالم السنن, he says فأما السنن المحضة, the ahadith that are only ahkam ahadith, فلم يقصد واحد منهم جمعها, no one can, had the intention of compiling it, okay, واستيفاءها, and to bring all of its corners together, ولم يقدر على تلخيصها واختصار مواضعها من أثناء تلك الأحاديث الطويلة ومن أدلة سياقها على ما اتفق لأبي داود, and to also what? Summarize it, abridge it, organize it, structure it, choose the ahadith which are long, but just take the parts that you need from it. No one did Allah give this ability to, and no one did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow for them to do it before Imam Abi Dawood. He was the first. And he also said, Imam al-Khattabi, he said, وَقَدْ جَمَعَ أَبِي دَاوُودَ فِي كِتَابِهِ مِنَ الْأَحَادِيثِ فِي أُصُولِ الْعِلْمِ وَأُمَّهَاتِ السُّنَنِ وَأَحْكَامِ الْفِقْهِ مَا لَا نَعْلَمُ مُتَقَدِّمًا مَا سَبَقَهُ إِلَيْهِ وَلَا مُتَأَخِّرًا لَحِقَهُ فِيهِ. He says, Al-Imam Abi Dawood, he compiled in his sunan ahadith which we can call the fundamental ahadith, and the ahadith which we can consider the ahadith which are the mothers. Ummahat al-Sunan, they were ahadith which were mothers. Mothers meaning they were the most needed ahadith. Wa ahkam al-fiqh, and he chose the most important ahadith al-fiqh. ما لا نعلم, we don't know, الإمام الخطابي saying متقدما ما سبقه إليه, that no one surpassed him or preceded him in this. ولا متأخرا, and we don't know anyone who came after him لحقه في, that reached him in this. No one reached him in this. سأل الإمام أبي داود كتاب is what? It's got a Mizah. لذلك brothers, Scholars, they say anyone who memorizes Sunnah Abi Dawood and understands it is a faqih. Is a what? Is a true jurist. If you do mudawamat al-nazar, meaning you consistently look at Sunnah Abi Dawood, and you go over this book a lot, and you do i'tikaf on it, then truly you will come out with what? You will truly come out with fiqh, comprehension of jurisprudent rulings that you would need at times of fatwa, when you want to give verdict. Like Al-Imam Ibn Abi Dawood's kitab has this miza, it has this unique thing over the other books. But don't think to yourself that the other books don't have things over Abi Dawood's Sunan. He has that over the other, or the others, but the others have over him other things as well. Like Al-Imam al-Nasa'i's kitab after Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, they say the most authentic one is Sunan Nasa'i. Al-Imam Abi Nasa'i Sunan is the most authentic after Bukhari and Muslim. That's what they say. So Nasa'i has more ahadith which are sahiha than what? Al-Imam Abi Dawood. And also Sunan Nasa'i, no one talks about it unless he has true knowledge of Mustalah al-Hadith Riwayatin wa Diraya. I mean, Ilmul Hadith Riwayatin wa Diraya. The person who wants to read Sunan al-Nasa'i, has to have what? True knowledge of Mustalah al-Hadith, the science of Hadith. Ilal, hidden defect in a Hadith, that person has to understand it. Because Sunan al-Nasa'i deals with a Hadith which are Ilal, a lot of it. That's just the istidlat, it's me going off topic. The third point that we want to mention, so how many points did we mention? We first mentioned the first thing, which was Ismul Kitab, the name of the book. We spoke about that. Then we spoke about the second one, which is Mawdu'ul Kitab. What is this? What does this book deal with? The third thing that we want to speak about is Mata Allafa Abu Dawood. When did Al-Imam Abi Dawood author Kitabahu Sunan? When did he write this Sunan? When did he put this book together? Mata, when did he put it together? What we can't do, brothers, is لا تمكننا, it is impossible on our side, من الجزم, to narrow down and specify بتحديد زمان التأليف, the time that he authored this book. It's something that we can't do. We can't say that Al-Imam Abi Dawood wrote it here, this time. But what we do know is Al-Imam Abi Dawood, he finished this book and he showed it to who? Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. That we know. Al-Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi mentions in his Tarikh al-Baghdad, the 9th volume, page 56, he says, وَقَدِيمَ بَغْدَادَ. Al-Imam Abi Dawood came to Baghdad غَيْرَ مَرَّةً, more than once. وَرَوَى كِتَابَهُ الْمُصَنَّفُ مصنف في السنن بها ونقله عنه أهلها. And Imam Abi Dawood, he narrated his book in Baghdad. And the people of Baghdad, they took it from him. ويقال, it is said, أنه صنفه قديما, that he authored this book early. وعارضه, and he presented it to who? على أحمد بن حنبل. He presented it to who? Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. فَاسْتَجَادَهُ. And Imam Ahmad loved it when he saw it. فَمَعْنَا فَاسْتَجَادَهُ, he saw it to be a good book, an amazing book. وَاسْتَحْسَنَهُ, and he said this book is good. Imam Abi Dawood, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. So this shows us that he authored the book when? He wrote it before Imam Ahmad died. And Imam Ahmad, when did he die? 241 Hijriah. Imam Ahmad precisely died 241. Imam Abi Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah, this is when he died. Imam Ahmad died 241 Hijriah. So what does this show? This shows us that Imam Abi Dawood gave it to Imam Ahmad, who died the year how many? 241. He gave it to him before then. He gave it to them Because Al-Imam Abi Dawood, how long did he, when did he die? He died 200 and what? 75, we mentioned it. Al-Imam Abi Dawood died 200 and what? 75. So how many years would that be after Al-Imam Ahmed? 34 years, right? It'll be roughly 34 years after who? Al-Imam Ahmed, he lived on. So of course, what did he do to the book? He would organize it, correct things that he thought were wrong. He would put a hadith back, bring it forward. But the first time he wrote it was when? That we can say is before Al-Imam Ahmed's death, which was 241. So we can't specifically narrow it down to a particular time in which he wrote it. All that we can say is that he wrote his kitab before the death of who? Al-Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. And Al-Imam Abi Dawood, don't ever think to yourself that he what? He just wrote it and he showed it to Imam Ahmed and Imam Ahmed praised it and that's where he left it. That's not the way of the scholars. If you look at the works that the scholars write, you always find, let's take ala sabili tamthili lal hasr. As an example, an Imam Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani rahimahullah. And Imam Albani rahimahullah, you find he wrote a book, and then he, in the beginning of the book, you find Taba'ati Thaniya, second publication. And then you find Taba'ati Thalitha on the same book. And then Taba'ati Thalitha, and sometimes it reaches Taba'ati Al-Ashira. Sometimes it even passes that. Because whilst the author is alive, his knowledge is enhancing. His understanding is increasing. And so what does he do? He says, if I put this one back and I put this one forward, it would be better. Are we together, brothers? And this shows us that completeness is only for what? And errorless is only for the Book of Allah. The Quran is the only thing that doesn't require any of that. And it doesn't need any of that. Because the Quran is, as Allah said in the Quran, لا يأتيه الباطل من بين لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد. صح? The Quran is what? Batil and falsehood does not come to it from the front, from the back. No way. It's from who? Allah تبارك وتعالى. أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. If the Quran was to come from who? من غيري من عند غير الله. If it was to come from other than Allah, لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. You would find contradictions in it. So all of the scholars, when they wrote books, they always looked at it and they said, I wish I just changed this. Why don't I take this out? Maybe this wasn't necessary for me to say. Maybe I shouldn't have used this term. Maybe. And correction comes from that. So Al-Imam Abi Dawood, what he was doing was tartiban wa iqra'an. He was reading this book. He was organizing this book for the many years after Al-Imam Ahmed rahimahullahu ta'ala. Until rather his death. He was doing that. ولذلك later when we speak about the narrators who narrated from the book, you'll see at the beginning of the book it says Sunan al-Imam Abi Dawud, Sulaiman ibn al-Ash'ath al-Sijistani, al-Mutawaffa sana, which it mentions the year he died, Hijriya. And then it says رواية اللؤلؤ مقارنة برواية ابن داسة وغيرها ضبط وحقق على 18 نسخة خطية. This is Dar al-Ta'sil I'm reading it from. So it says رواية اللؤلؤ. Who's اللؤلؤ? مقارنة compared with برواية ابن داسة. Who's ابن داسة? These are going to come to us. We shouldn't be مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا. We're carrying a book, we don't understand what's happening, what's the beginning, what does it say? Who's this person? Who's لؤلؤي? These are people, inshallah, we're going to talk about are the narrators of Sunan Abi Dawood. They narrated it from him. Anyone who wants to take an ijazah on Sunan Abi Dawood, he's going to go through these narrators. Because they're the ones who took this kitab from Al-Imam Abi Dawood. But they're different. Why is Lu'lu'i different from Ibn Dasa? Who from amongst them has received Ardatul Akhira, the last presentation of Al-Imam Abi Dawood? Because I just said Al-Imam Abi Dawood, what was he doing? He was changing the book. He was pulling things forward and things backwards. He was rectifying and changing things that he believed needed to be rectified. So there is a person who takes the ardatul akhira. Sahih? Doesn't the Quran have not, does it not have ardatul akhira? The last presentation of the Quran. Which companion took it from the Prophet? Ardatul akhira? Yeah, Zayd ibn Thabit, did he not take it? Ardatul akhira? So we're going to see that inshaAllah ta'ala. So Imam Abi Dawood was doing that. The fourth point that we're going to now go into inshaAllah ta'ala is tajzi'atul kitab. Breaking down, sisters if you can be quiet inshaAllah ta'ala, barakallahu feekum. Sisters if you can be quiet inshaAllah ta'ala. Tajzi'atul kitab. We're now going to break the what? We're going to break down the book inshaAllah ta'ala. Al-Imam Abi Dawood mentions in his Risalatihi ila Ahli Makkah, how many books are inside the Sunan. In each kitab, you see there's a book inside it. Kitab al-Tahara, Kitab al-Salah, Kitab al-Zakat, Kitab al-Sawm, Kitab al-Hajj. How many kitabs does this book have? The books that are in the Sunan Abi Dawood are 18 books. How many books? 18 books. How many added, what's the added of the kutub in Sunan Abi Dawood? 18. And we inshallah ta'ala, and I request from all of you, if you can all try to get the Darul Ta'seel, this copy. This copy is the best copy of Sunan Abi Dawood. I will speak about why this is the best copy when we speak about the taba'at of the kitab. Okay, point number five, inshaAllah ta'ala. Taba'atul kitab, the publication of the book. And Imam Abi Dawood's Sunan, the first time it was actually published, and it was published, meaning it was copied and it was made into a book, was when the year was 1271. This was the first time that it was published and it was brought out. This is when it was first copied. Now inshallah ta'ala, we're going to mention the earliest of those copies was Taba'atu Delhi. The Taba'a that was done in India, New Delhi right now. When the year was 1271. Until 1272, it was being worked on. Okay? Meaning they first published it again, and the second time they published it was the year after again, and then they published the year, 10 years later after that they published it again. This was no one preceded India in publishing Sunan Abi Dawood. And New Delhi was the first place that they published. And this is a very common thing that you're going to see. That when you look at Taba'atul Kutub, the people who preceded people in it, especially Kutub al-Hadith, is who? India is the early place in which it was published. Then after that, Tubi'a fil Qahira. Qahira, it got published. Which is called the Taba'atul Kasatiliya. Taba'atu al Kasiti. I think it's the scene goes before the ta, or the ta before the scene, I'm not sure. But it's called a Taba'atul Kasatiliya. This was the publication that Egypt came out with, and the year that it was done was 1280. And it was done in two volumes, fi mujalladaini, two volumes it was done in. And then again after that it got published again in India, when the year was 1305. Now, India, because they published it first, they don't want to publish it just like its normal self. So what they did this year was that they published it with the ta'liqat of Al-Imam Al-Khattabi rahimahullah on the Hawamish. Again, they brought out the first ta'liq on the book. And then it got published in Qahira again with the side note of who? The sharh of Zarqani and the Muwatta of Imam Malik. They placed that on the bottom when the year was 1310. And then it got published in Lucknow again. Lucknow, which is in what? In India again. They published it again. And the publication was better than all of the publications before that. And at the bottom, they placed the sharah of it, the Hamish on it, the Aunul Udud, Sharh Sunan Abi Dawood by Abil Hasanat. They placed his on it, which was two volumes. And then the sixth time was the Taba'a in Hyderabad. Hyderabad, Deccan, with Darul Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyah. They published it in the year 1391. And they published it again 1393. The best publication of the kitab then, it was the Taba'a, which is the Taba'atul Hajariyah. Taba'a Hajariyah is the best, which was done in India. Taba'atul Hajariyah, it was called, and it was published in India when the year was 1323. This is the best publication. And it was done in four volumes. Very big, thick. If you go to India right now, Jama'a Salafiyah Banaris, they have it. And they also have it in Hyderabad, Deccan. Dar al-Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyah, they have this publication. وَهِيَ أَجْوَدُ الطَّبَعَاتِ. It's the best taba'at in terms of Dabt of Sunan Abi Dawud. In terms of the what? The matan and the hadiths. And Dar al-Ta'seel, which is the one I have with me, they used it, they applied it. So they used this one. The second one is, the second publication, which is very good, is the taba'a of Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid was one of the greatest muhaqqiqin. And he also has a sharah on what? Ajrumiyah. It's called Tuhfatu Saniyah. Huh? Fi sharh muqaddimat al-Ajrumiyah. He has a sharah on it. He also is a great muhaqqiq. He done tahqiqat of many books. So he done the tahqiq of Sunan Abi Dawood. There's also another one, which is the tahqiq of Al-Sheikh Muhammad Awama, which is five volumes. It's out. The sixth volume is just a faharis. The sixth volume is what? Is a faharis, meaning it's a content page. And what I did was, in Haram al-Madani, in the Prophet's Masjid, I took Sunan Abi Dawood Dar al-Ta'seel, and I took the taba'a of Muhammad Awama. And I realized that Al-Imam Abi Dawood Sunan, that the tahqiq of Muhammad Awama, he played with it. Any ahadith that go against what he believes, he takes it out. That go against his mu'taqad and what he believes. So I wouldn't advise anybody to buy it. The taba'a that was published by Muhammad Awama, the five volume one, that I saw, it's best that one does not waste his money and his time on it. لِأَنَّهُ فِيهِ سَقَطَاتِ. In it there's many things that he took out, and I've written it on the ghallaf of my Sunan Abi Dawood, on the front page of it, all of the places that he played with it. And we didn't just compare, I didn't just compare it with the Sunan Abi Dawood Dar al-Ta'seel. I compared it with the other taba'at that we had, taba'at Dar al-Salam and the taba'at that were published. We compared that with it. Even Maktabat al-Ma'arif al-Riyadh, we compared it with that one as well, but we realized that there's so many things that he has dropped. Now I want to go into the ruwat who narrated Sunan Abi Dawood. I defined Sunan Abi Dawood's kitab. The first point that I was going to do was what? Ta'rifu bi Sunan Abi Dawood. I'm still in the first chapter, by the way, first unit, which is At-Ta'rifu bi Sunan Abi Dawood. We define the book. How did we define the book? We spoke about Ismul Kitab, the name of the book. We spoke about Mawdu'ul Kitab, what the book deals with. We spoke about when did the author write the book. We also talked about Tajzi'atul Kitab. How did Imam Abi Dawood organize this book, or how did he break it down? The fifth thing that we spoke about is the taba'atul kitab, the publications that the book went through. Those are 5 points that we mentioned. We're now going to go into ruwatu sunani, sunani al-imam Abi Dawud. Who are the narrators who narrated sunan Abi Dawud? The narrators who narrated from al-imam Abi Dawud, adharuwat, who narrated from al-imam Abi Dawud are jama'atun kathirun. There are many people in number. They're large. We can't narrow it down to a number. And as I said, in Baghdad, many people heard it from him. Okay? لَكِنَّ الَّذِينَ اشْتَهَرُوا But like in the people who became famous, بِرِوَايَتِهِ عَنْهُ They became famous from narrating from him with asanid which are muttasila. The chain that they narrated, Sunan Abi Dawud, is connected. Are five. There are five people. The first one of them is Abu Ali Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Amr al-Lu'lu'i al-Basri. Who died the year 333. It's the one you have on the beginning of the book, Biriwayat al-Lu'lu'i. Abu Ali Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Amr al-Lu'lu'i al-Basri. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, when he spoke about him, he said in his Sir Alam al-Nubala, the 15th volume, page 207, he said, Al-Imam al-Muhaddith al-Saduq, the Imam, the Muhaddith, the Saduq, the truthful one. So he's talking about who? Al-Imam Abu Ali Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Amr al-Lu'lu'i. He's Saduq, he's a trustworthy person. And the riwayatul Lu'lu'i, the riwayat of Lu'lu'i, of Al-Imam Abi Dawud, he asahhu riwayat, it's the most authentic chain of narration. Meaning it's the most authentic narrator. Why? لِأَنَّهَا مِنْ آخِرِ مَا أَمْلَأَ أَبُو دَاوُدِ لِأَنَّهَا Because the reason is because it is مِنْ آخِرِ It's the last مَا أَمْلَأَ أَبُو دَاوُدِ It's the last thing that Imam Abi Dawud dictated. So this is the عَرْضَةُ الْأَخِيرَةِ Lu'lu'i is the what? Lu'lu'i is what? It's عَرْضَةُ الْأَخِيرَةِ Meaning, it's the last presentation that Al-Imam Abi Dawud put. The last person who took Sunnah Abi Dawud is Lu'lu'i. Al-Imam Abi Dawud, as I said, how many times did he read this book? Many times. He dictated it how many times? Many times. وَقَدْ سَمِعَ السُّنَنَ And he heard the Sunan, Al-Imam Lu'lu'i, he heard the Sunan from Al-Imam Abi Dawud مَرَّاتٍ عَدِيدًا Many times. Al-Lu'lu'i heard this many times. And the last time that he heard it from him was when the year was what? 200 and what? 75. When did Al-Imam Abi Dawud die? Huh? He heard it from him in the year Al-Imam Abi Dawud died. He heard it from him in the year that Al-Imam Abi Dawud died. Sanati allati tuwfiya fiha Abu Dawud. This is what Ibn Nuqta mentions in his kitab At-Taqyid li-ma'rifati الروات السنن والمسانيد and السيوطي brings it in his كتاب البحر الذي زغر that الإمام that it said that كان أبو علي اللؤلؤي قد قرأ هذا الكتاب على أبي داود 20 years 20 years he read this book on him وكان يسمى وراقة he was actually called the scriber huh? He was a scriber of Al-Imam Abi Dawud. وَالْوَرَّاقُ عِنْدَهُمُ الْقَارِ He was the one who read it on him, and he was the one who took it for him. وَلَكِنْ هُوَ الْقَارِئُ لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ يَسْمَعُونَ And Imam Abi Dawud, who was the one who used to read on him the Sunan, that whenever Al-Imam Abi Dawud would read this book, he would be the one who would read it for him. Who was it? Al-Lu'lu'i. Ulama, they had people who read for them. Al-Lu'lu'i was the one who used to read for him. قَالَ الشَّيْخُ وَلِيُّ الدِّينَ أَبُو زُرْعَةَ الرَّازِيُّ Sorry, الشَّيْخُ الْوَلِيُّ الدِّينَ أَبُو زُرْعَةَ الْعِرَاقِي Al-Imam Zainuddin al-Iraqi's son. You know Zainuddin al-Iraqi, right? Zainuddin al-Iraqi, the one who wrote the Alfiyah. Alfiyah al-Iraqi. Yeah? He has a son. Zainuddin al-Iraqi is what? He's a teacher of Ibn Hajar. Zainuddin al-Iraqi is the teacher of Ibn Hajar. His son is who? Waliyuddin. Abu Zur'at al-Iraqi, he said, وقد سمعه اللؤلؤي من أبي داود سنة وفاته. That Lu'lu'i heard this book from Al-Imam Abi Dawood سنة وفاته, the year that he died. وهي سنة خمس وسبعين ومئتين. And this was when 200 and what? 275. فينبغي أن يكون العمل على روايته. So in terms of implementation, Sunan Abi Dawood should be implemented based on who? Based on the riwayat al-Lu'lu'i. Because the last, this is what Abi Dawood wanted. He's got the authentic, the last version. So that's why Daru Ta'seel said riwayat al-Lu'lu'i muqaranatan bi riwayat Ibn Dasa. And why did they compare Ibn Dasa with it? We'll see why. But the relying of this book is what? So when you open Daru Ta'seel, when you open it and you read the top part of the hadith, what is the riwayah on the top? The riwayah to Lu'lu'i. At the bottom, if there's differences, which one is he going to mention for you? Riwayah Ibn Dasa. They'll say Ibn Dasa's riwayah goes against Lu'lu'i based on this word. It stays this word instead of this word. Are we all together, brothers? That's how you know when you're using the book. So Waliyuddin Al-Iraqi, the son of Zainuddin Al-Iraqi, mentioned something very powerful. He said, فَيَنْبَغِي أَنْ يَكُونَ الْعَمَلُ عَلَى رِوَايَتِهِ, that the riwayat al-lu'lu'i should be what we implement, or it should be what we rely on, not at the other riwayat. This is very important, and it's a point that you should underline. Who narrated from Lu'lu'i? Who took from Lu'lu'i the Sunan Abi Dawood? Al-Qasim ibn Ja'far ibn Abdul Wahid al-Hashimiyu Abu Umar al-Basriyu, who died a year 322. He was born 322 and he died a year 414. And he's from the Shuyukh of who? Umar al-Basri, al-Qasim ibn Ja'far ibn Abdul Wahid al-Hashimiyu, Abu Umar al-Basri, he is the teacher of al-Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi. This is Khatib al-Baghdadi's teacher. ولذلك Khatib al-Baghdadi said about him, كان ثقة أمينا ولي القضاء. He said he was a trustworthy, honest person. ولي القضاء بالبصرة. He became a governor in Basra. وسمعت منه بها سنة أبي داود. And I heard from him سنة أبي داود. خطيب البغدادي saying this. Like I took it from him. So who took from القاسم بن جعفر ابن عبد الواحد الهاشمي أبو عمر البصري, who took from him? الإمام, huh? Who took from him? I just told it to you. خطيب البغدادي. Then we have الإمام أبي داود. Who took from Imam Abi Dawood? Al-Lu'lu'i. Who took from Lu'lu'i? Abu Umar al-Basri. Who took from Abu Umar al-Basri? Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. And Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, he died in 463 taqriban. He died in 463 taqriban. And he was Imam ma'ruf. Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi is ma'ruf. He's well known. And the riwayah of Al-Imam Al-Khatib Al-Baghdadi هي التي اعتمدت. And it is that riwayah that became the nuskha which is shai'. It became the copy which spread. And it became the nuskha which was mu'tamad. It was relied on by the scholars. This is what they relied on. The riwayah of Al-Imam Al-Khatib Al-Baghdadi. So if you have a sanad to riwayah Lu'lu'i, you're going to have to go through who? Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. Another benefit that we take. Al-Imam al-Sakhawi rahimahullah. Sakhawi is who, brothers? So we have the student of Ibn Hajar now. Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi rahimahullah. He is the what? He's the sharih of Al-Fit al-Iraqi. He explained it. He called it Fath al-Mughith fi sharhi Alfiyat al-Hadith. Sahih? He's the one, Al-Imam السخاوي رحمه الله he said لم ينفرد الخطيب عن الهاشمي pay attention now. إذن خطيب البغدادي is not the only person who narrated from الهاشمي. Who's الهاشمي? أبو عمر البصري. He's not the only person who narrated from him. بل هو أيضا عندنا من طريق أبي علي التستري. أبو علي التستري is also another person who narrated from him. He died the year 479 هجرية. He also narrated from who? الهاشمي رحمه الله. If you want his ترجمة, in details is given in the kitab سير على من نبلاء, the 18th volume. Also, أبي منصور ابن يشكرية. They all narrated from Abu Umar. If you now take the riwayah of Khatib al-Baghdadi, who narrated from al-Hashimi, and the riwayah of Abu Ali as-Tustari, even though they all narrated from who? Al-Hashimi, and al-Hashimi narrated from who? Al-Lu'iyu, there's a difference still. Khatib al-Baghdadi's copy has a slight difference to the copy of who? Abu Ali as-Tustari. Even though they all narrated from who? They all narrated from al-Imam, الإمام القاسم بن جعفر بن عبد الواحد الهاشمي رحمه الله تعالى. The riwayah of Lu'lu'i, as we said, brothers, is the most famous riwayah, the most well-known riwayah. ولذلك the scholars, when they say Sunan Abi Dawood, unrestrictedly, they always mean the riwayah of Lu'lu'i. If you say, I read Sunan Abi Dawood, I studied Sunan Abi Dawood, just like that, you're referring to which one? الرواية اللؤلؤي. إذا أطلق, if it's unrestrictedly said, it goes back to رواية اللؤلؤي. But if it's the other رواة that you narrate, that you study their copy, you have to say سنن أبي داود برواية ابن داسة. You have to mention the رواية of the person you heard it from. If you go to India, for example, in India, riwayat al-lu'lu'iyu is what's depended on. Bilad al-Hijaz, Bilad al-Mashriqi, min al-Arab of course. But rather the majority of the lands, when you use the word Sunan Abi Dawood, it is biriwayat al-lu'lu'iyu. It's the riwayah of his. Ibn Raslan, who I have today, the great Shafi'i scholar, Shahabuddin Ibn Raslan rahimahullah ta'ala, who died the year 844 rahimahullah, he has a sharah and is a great Shafi'i imam. His taba'a just recently came out, roughly 3 years ago taqriban, or 4 years ago. What year are we in? Gregorian calendar? 2018, right? So it came out 2015. How much is that? تقريبا 3 years. So this copy is out only for 3 years. Many of the scholars, they used to bring out the sharah of Ibn Raslan through a wasita, through a means, meaning somebody else copied it from his copy. They would narrate it from there. Like for example, Sheikh Nasir Rahimahullah Albani never saw this copy. Some people never saw it because it wasn't published. It wasn't brought out. And this copy has miza. We'll speak about that later when we spoke about the shurah and the reason why we chose to rely on this sharah. Because the majority of the people here are Shafi'iyah, right? Yeah? No? The majority of the people here are Shafi'iyah, sahih? Huh? Ya ahl al-Somal, you guys Shafi'iyah, right? So, we will rely on the sharah of Ibn Raslan, due to the fact him being Shafi'i, and of course if we disagree with him al-Masail, we'll mention it inshallah ta'ala. So that's the sharah Ibn Raslan relied on, riwayat al-Lu'lu'i. Hafid al-Iraqi, he also relied on that. Ibn al-Qayyim has a kitab called Tahdhib al-Sunan, Sunan Abi Dawud. He relied on riwayat al-Lu'lu'i. Suyuti, he relied on al-Lu'lu'i's riwayah. Zayla'i Nisb al-Raya, Mishkat al-Masabih, بلوغ المرام. If you go to the كتاب المنتقى, جامع الأصول by Ibn Athir, بلوغ المرام by Ibn Hajar, المنتقى by أبو البركات مجد الدين ابن تيمية, which is the شرح Shawkani done a sharh on it called it Nailul Awtar, which is the sharh of the Muntaqa by Abu al-Barakat Ibn Majduddin Ibn Taymiyyah. Jami' al-Usul by Ibn Athir. If you go to Bulugh al-Maram, if you go to the Kitab Arba'in al-Nawiyyah, Riyadh al-Salihin, when they say Rawahu Abu Dawood, they mean Riwayat al-Lu'lu'i. That's what they all mean. They're all relying on which one? Al-Riwayat al-Lu'lu'i. That's what it is. Even Tahdhib al-Kamal by Abu al-Hajjaj al-Miziyu, this is what he relies on. Ibn Asakir has a kitab called Al-Ishraf ala Ma'rifat al-Atraf, where he talks about the atraf of the ahadiths. He brings the riwayat al-lu'lu'i of Sunan Abi Dawud. Then what I'm trying to say is, inna riwayat al-lu'lu'i min asahhi al-riwayat, wallahu a'lam. The most authentic riwayat that is there that the scholars rely on is the riwayat al-lu'lu'i. And then of course, to enhance your understanding of the book, and sometimes the other riwayat, they can be for you like a sharah. It can. If you take the other wordings that he used and you compare it, it can explain to you what he meant by this. Are we together, brothers? But the backbone and the one that you rely on is the riwayat al-lu'lu'i. Inshallah ta'ala, we will leave it tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, to speak about the other riwayat out there of Sunnah Abi Dawood. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.